U.S. Army's Future Stealth Attack Helicopter. The U.S. Army's attack helicopters that fly high and slow, and that can fly low and quick, can fight at night, and can be more intellectually simple to fly, allowing the crew to focus on the combat. Significant General Walter Rugen, director of the Future Vertical Lift Cross-Functional Team in the U.S. Army Futures Command, mentioned the objective facts at a discussion held by the Center for Strategic and International Studies. Rugen's assertion comes in the background of the Army's two essential acquirement programs, the Future Long-Range Assault Helicopter and the Future Attack Helicopter. Both are essential for the bigger Future Vertical Lift, FVL, project. While the Future Long-Range Assault Helicopter is meant to replace the Sikorsky S-80 Black Hawk, the Future Attack Helicopter is meant as a replacement for the H-64 Apache. Both are targeted to happen by the 2030s. For the Future Long-Range Assault Aircraft, Sikorsky-Boeing's Defiant X, a contra-rotor, or coaxial rotor, helicopter, and Bell's V-280 slant rotor, both technology demonstrators, were extensively tested. The Future Attack Aircraft, meanwhile, has Bell's 360 Invictus and Sikorsky's Raider X as contenders, where the latter is a shorter, slightly modified version of the Defiant X. Lesson from Russia and Ukraine. Saying that speed and range would permit future rotorcraft to stay out of the range of surface-to-air attacks showed Rugen was discussing the few Russian Komovka 52 and Mi-17 helicopters shot down in Ukraine and other comparable Ukrainian helicopters like the Mi-8 that fell to Russian air defense. In any case, these misfortunes probably happened in light of the fact that these helicopters were inside the adversary's or inside kill zone. This means the Army is looking at employing the chaos and confusion in the middle of the battlefield to reduce the chances of becoming surface-to-air missile and air defense targets. Intellectual cockpit, single-window data sharing and longer-range missiles. First is a more intellectually accessible cockpit that can share a more significant load of the flying while the crew and pilots focus on the fighting bit. Rugen hopes this can be achieved with dual-use sensors in response to a question regarding what complementary technologies he believes can believe low-fast flying and autonomous cockpits. When a sensor isn't doing survivability, might it at any point do lethality? Might it at any point do assurance from obstructions and debased visual conditions? A multi-use sensor takes care of into the capacity to complete a few errands the cockpit is extremely stressed over. We maintain that the cockpit should be intellectually simpler than today. Second is the ability to collate, process, and beam data from multiple assets and allied forces, like NATO countries, on a bound-together connection point, which Rugen called a solitary sheet of glass, empowering quicker and more viable direction. Third is more prominent stalemate ability with missile arriving at in excess of 30 kilometers, over two times that Rugen's age used to with the AGM-114 Hellfire's 11 kilometers range. Those that didn't have it, standoff, had much tougher days, and those that had that standoff were decisive against long-range fires which they were able to reduce, he concluded. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.